us a break?
Why don't you snake slither under the rocks you came from?
Then where are you gonna sleep, Johnny?
Johnny, come on.
Hey, Johnny, you kill anybody lately?
No, but you're giving me a good idea. Let's go.
Come on, honey, I'm gonna make you a story. I'll give you something real special.
What'd you have to do that for?
Is it my fault he's no taller than the door?
We're just friends, Johnny.
You know what your problem is, honey? Your problem is you don't know who your friends really are.
Maybe my problem is they're all like you. Good night.
Women.
Hey, Johnny, how about one for the Hollywood Confidential? As far as we're concerned, you're the real star here, baby.
Tell me where do they go? The smoke rings I blow each night. What do they do? Why do they seem to picture a dream of love? Why do they fade my phantom parade of love?
I always like it when they burn down a little bit.
Time travel is a reality, and it's fallen into criminal hands. With history itself at risk, the United States has formed the Time Enforcement Commission, a top secret agency responsible for policing the temporal stream. Track unlawful travelers across time. Their mission, protect the past, preserve the future. These agents are known as Time Cops.
Got it.
Best lady of the year?
1956. I've had bigger scratches than this ripple.
Really? Where?
Okay, folks, give me a reason to worry about a ripple this small.
It's been caused by the death of one Johnny the Chin Fontaine, a bagman for the Genovese family. He was supposed to die September 3rd, 1956, but he died 2 weeks early.
I don't mean to seem unprofessional, but maybe that's a good thing.
Not necessarily. He was supposed to die taking a bullet that was meant for Rita Lake.
The actress?
In 1956, she was a rising star. Unfortunately, she was being stalked by someone. Someone obsessed with her.
Hey, I like movies as much as the next guy, but we can't even be certain that bullet will kill her. I don't have the resources to send a time cop back on the chance some actress may be murdered.
She went on to win an Academy Award.
So did Rin Tin Tin.
She also married Senator Charles Warren. They had a son, Albert Baker Warren, who grew up to be...
44th President of the United States.
If she dies, It could affect the course of world history.
All right. Let's target whoever's stalking Rita Lake and arrest him. Logan, suit up and find out who's trying to kill her. Let's go, people. Lock it down.
Launch at 2 minutes and counting.
Pressure nominal on the board. Prepare to drop Hartman.
The 50s were thought of as the time of innocence. Malt shops, drive-in theaters, carefree prom night.
Hey, don't even mention prom nights to me. Lois Hill dumped me 3 days before my junior prom.
You, Jack Logan, dumped?
The same stunned reaction, Emmys.
But help me grow. Thank you. And still fit into the sled. Ready?
Hit me with an Elvis concert.
I guess your favorite tune would be Heartbreak Hotel.
Initiate temporal download. Now.
See you later, alligator.
Well, I saw my baby walking with another man today.
Music from the 50s.
Launch countdown at 30 seconds.
To it.
After a while, cut down.
Then the launch pad.
See you later, alligator. Reminded her of what she said.
See you later, alligator.
Hi.
Hi.
Can you direct me to the men's department?
It's too right.
Thanks very much. Oh, that dress? It's you.
There's no evidence of explosive residue anywhere. It must have been some sort of short circuit in the electrical system.
How can he be electrocuted by a cigarette lighter?
What, do I look like an electrician to you? There's no evidence of foul play here, Joe. Case closed.
Boy, I don't think AAA's gonna cover this one.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, I'm starting a neighborhood watch. What's the cause of death?
Smoking.
All right, let's clear it out. Everybody.
Man, oh man, two detective eats this crap up.
You at the studios, right?
One of those PR boys looking to cover Rita's back? Am I on point here?
I got you figured for a name or a leech. Am I on point here?
Define amoral.
Microwave receptor, shortwave. Not very 50. 50s.
What are you doing?
Drop my matches.
Let me give you a light.
I must have left my smokes in the car.
Have one of mine. So, you're a reporter?
No.
So what are you doing here?
Just thought you might need someone to talk to.
So you mean the studio sent you?
Well, not exactly. Nice house. How long you lived here?
Just moved in 6 months ago. Right after I signed my studio deal. Beats the heck out of that rat trap I left in Burbank.
Two Mile. Oh, well, did you know Johnny?
Well enough to know I didn't like him.
What about his friends? It's no secret someone's been after you.
If a mob guy was trying to kill me, I'd already be dead. Now, this is, it's much spookier.
What do you mean?
I hear rustling outside my house at night, footsteps following me, just creepy stuff.
It's like a B-movie.
It's like a bad B-movie. And I don't know how this one's gonna end.
Don't worry. In Hollywood, there's always a happy ending.
Rita Lake.
Jack Logan.
It's nice to meet you, Jack.
We're getting a better class of clientele.
Barry Manilow. Thank you.
Thank you.
You've been tailing me?
That's a good guess.
Don't you have more important things to do?
Well, you know, sometimes the unimportant things amuse me. Like you, for instance.
Well, you should get a real big kick out of yourself, then.
I don't like a smart mouth. Now, you have two choices. You can talk to me here, or you can talk to me downtown. It's your call.
Let me show you something.
Whoa. Well, it looks like some wacko's really got the hots for Rita. Well, there must be 1,000 guys just like him in this city.
I think you're missing the point. Only someone completely obsessed with her would do something like this. I think she could be in real danger.
And I could care less about what you think.
And they actually pay you for that attitude.
Look, pal. I get paid to solve crimes. So far, I don't see one. Unless you'd like me to call at you for breaking and entering. No, I didn't think so. Why don't you just go back to the studio and tell Sam Berman to leave the police work to me?
Accident I had in the car. Just a mild cigarette burn.
Stay away from me.
Oh, come on, Rita. You know you can't hurt a ghost. I've been looking forward to this, Rita, for a very long time.
Contact Jay Logan.
Unscrambling the cipher. Logan must have found something critical to his investigation. He's securing it for retrieval.
I'll tell Matusak Logan's onto something and sending it back.
I was so thrilled to hear about your marriage. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much. Actually, I was hoping to get a little advice from you.
From me?
Oh, yes.
On marriage?
No, on children.
Oh, wonderful. You're going to have children. Well, the first thing I...
Five minutes, Miss Lake.
Yeah.
So I got a call that somebody broke into your house last night.
A little late in arriving, aren't you?
Well, I had one homicide and an arson. A B&E wasn't exactly my top priority.
I wouldn't buckle under that kind of pressure.
You see this line? This line runs through the entire city. And whenever you and I meet, it's going to be there. And if you ever cross it again, that's going to be the last move you ever make. You got that?
I'll keep that in mind. Excuse me.
So, can you give me a description of the man who broke in?
I got info Mr. Berman's going to be real interested in. You want a deal?
He looked just like Johnny Fontaine.
I'd be happy to question Johnny, but I don't think I'd get much out of him.
What kind of information?
About the guy who's stalking Rita?
You know who it is?
I might, for the right price. And that'd be in the four figures, by the way. Meet me at the Starlight Bowl at closing time. Bring cash and come along.
Thank you.
Here you are, sir.
What do you make of this?
This cover's from 1957, so what's it doing in 1956? And the DVD wasn't even developed till the late 90s.
Exactly. What have you got?
Trouble. This cover is a reproduction of the original. The paper that was used to copy it is from a polymorphic fiber with a compound carbon base.
I got eyes, Hemmings. I know a polymorphic carbon, whatever it is, when I see one.
Hold this.
Yes, Ms. Wizard.
Watch. This paper hasn't even been invented yet. It's from the future. Our future. And whoever used it wanted to make sure it survived the trip back to 1956.
1957 picture of Rita, the DVD. This guy obviously wanted Logan to know he's there. Does this mean we have more than one stalker after Rita Lake?
This is nice, Jack.
A little corny, I guess, for someone like you.
Someone like me. Rhoda Lakeland from Davenport, Iowa. Can you get cornier than that? Thought I hated my real name, but Rita Lake just doesn't feel like me.
I think it suits you.
Suits what I've become. I'm not sure I like that much either.
You know what I think?
What?
I think you're too tough on yourself. You're special, Rita. Just gonna have to learn to live with that.
And you're sweet. You remind me of the boys back home, which is where I feel I ought to be.
Miss Lake, I've come to take you to the studio.
Hi, Stan. Just give me a second.
You're leaving?
Got a picture to finish, Jack.
I don't think it's safe for you to go back there.
I'll be at the studio. There are guards everywhere. Need pass to get in. I'll be fine. So, can I see you later?
You could count on it.
Let me guess, what do you average, 98?
Bowling's not my favorite pastime.
What is?
Traveling. Tell me what you got.
Step into my office. What I got is gonna rock your socks. I'm telling you, this info is so hot that it would get me into a heap of trouble. So, please, before I spill the beans, let me see the bread. I know who's gonna kill Rita. It's...
Dead men tell no tales. Don't you just love a good cliche, Jack?
Ian Pascoe, what are you doing here? Haven't seen you since London, 1888.
Well, isn't it clear? I'm here to kill you. Ready to rock and roll, Jack? Pesky 7-10 spread. You know, I think the trick is to angle the shot. Attention, bowlers! We have a red light special on lane 6. I'm going for a personal best, Jack!
you stalking Rita?
The most beautiful actress in history? Well, who better to murder her than the greatest killer in history?
Real good reason for being here.
I like bowling. You got a problem with that?
No, I got a problem with you. I got a tip Joe Arturo had something for you. You were meeting him here.
Tip from who?
Maybe you haven't figured it out yet. I'm an LAPD detective. I got a lot of sources. So where's Joe?
Gone.
Gone. See, I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I think you're full of crap. So why don't we go on back inside? Come on. Is it my imagination or does trouble just follow you wherever you go?
Well, you've been following me, haven't you?
Oh, see, this is interesting. This is very interesting. You know, this reminds me a lot of Johnny Fontaine the last time I saw him. You know, and as I recall, you were there, too.
You have a point here.
Maybe you killed them both. Come on, come on. If you confess now, I promise I'll recommend to the DA that you only get life. Huh? But no, what's the matter? See, now you're not talking. What, are you waiting for your lawyer? You remember that line I told you about?
Yeah.
You just crossed it.
How far advanced is the technology that was used?
The composition of this is at least 20 years ahead of ours.
So our stalker is from 2027.
And he's left a trail for Logan. The magazine cover a year ahead of its time, the digital video player.
Logan's being trapped.
Does it sound like anyone we know?
Ripper.
Bingo.
Whoa, hold up. I just found something of some historical significance. It seems there was a detective who investigated the death of Johnny Fontaine by the name of Nolte.
So?
Well, naturally, he was involved with several other homicide investigations, but five of them were of men who had dated Rita Lake.
And they were all murdered?
In exactly the same way, with a .38 caliber bullet, standard police issue in 1956.
Were the killers ever found?
They're written off as mob hits, but I dug a little deeper, and...
None of the victims was actually involved with the mob.
Right. They were only involved with Rita Lake. Nolte closed the files on all of them within a few weeks.
You know, there's a stalker from 1956 after Rita. Think this Nolte could be him?
I'd say the probability of that is quite high.
Posted bail for me?
Mr. Logan, sorry about all this.
And you are?
Rita Lake's attorney.
How'd she know I was arrested?
I have no idea. She wouldn't even tell me where she was calling from.
I guess a girl can't be too careful.
Well, actually, you know, it's a bit of an inconvenience. I have about 20 contracts for her to sign.
Right now, I think Rita's got more important things on her mind.
Look, Mr. Logan, if Rita's in some kind of trouble, I'd like to help.
If she wanted your help, I'm sure she would have confided in you.
Well, not everybody confides in their lawyers. Some people have the impression we're a cold and uncaring lot.
Even in 1956, huh?
Oh, I think that sentiment has been expressed throughout the ages. Wasn't it Shakespeare who said, "Let's kill all the lawyers"?
Fan of the Bard's plays, are you?
My dear friend, I was there when he wrote them.
It's a dangerous world we're living in, Jack. Wrought with peril.
You, of all people, you're less trusting.
Jack, look around. We don't want anybody hurt.
Let me ask you one thing. Why Rita?
And I know it's not just because she's beautiful.
True enough. A woman's beauty is such a fleeting thing.
It's because she gives birth to the 44th President of the United States, right?
Bravo, Jack. You've just won the bonus round. You see, if you try hard enough, you can change history.
I'm not going to let you do that.
Jack, you can't stop me. But because you're such a smart boy, and because I know that you care so much about Rita, I'm going to reward you. You see, I'm going to let you live just long enough to watch her die.
Hey, fella, could you give me a hand? I'm kind of stuck a long way from home.
Where's home?
2007.
Hemmings. Wow.
Yeah, well, you know, it's what they wore. I researched it. I did. How's it going?
Just had a conversation with Ian Pascoe.
And live to tell about it?
He's stalking Rita.
Yeah, well, we have another problem. It's a detective named Nolte.
Nolte?
We think the bullet Johnny Fontaine was supposed to take for Rita was fired by Nolte.
Stay close to Nolte. I'm going to check on Rita, make sure she's okay.
Could you get my hood?
Does this thing actually work?
Whoa.
Whoa. Clutch, Hemmings. Clutch!
What's a clutch?
Good. Goodbye.
Straight on back.
And you're sure about the time? Yeah, and you sure that she'll be there? Yeah. All right, yeah. Yes?
Officer, I was just walking down the street minding my own business and someone ran up behind me and snatched my purse.
Did you happen to read the sign on the door? It says, homicide. I investigate murders, not purse snatchings.
Oh, God. I'm really sorry. You know, I'm so frazzled. You know, it's not easy being a woman alone in this city.
Alone?
Yeah.
I wouldn't have thought someone like you would be unattached.
Oh, well, you know, I meet a lot of guys. I guess I just haven't met the right one, you know. How about you? You married?
Divorced. Look, why don't you leave me your name and number, and I'll have the desk sergeant file a report on the purse.
Thank you. That is so nice of you.
Well, you know our motto, miss, to protect and serve.
Oh, Claire, please. Call me Claire.
Rick. Look, I'm really very sorry. I have a meeting with my captain, so...
Oh, of course, I understand. God, you've been so nice to me. Do you mind if I use your phone? See, all my keys were in my purse. Now I have to call my landlord to get in my apartment.
No, please. Be my guest. No, it's...
Thanks, Rick. Here's my name and number. After you give it to the desk sergeant, you can keep it if you'd like.
I might do that.
Supposed to stay out of sight.
I know, but I'm supposed to be shooting tonight. It's my big death scene. Kind of ironic, huh? Yes?
Rita, it's Sam Berman. I just got a call from the director wondering when you'll be arriving on set.
Mr. Berman, I'll be there right away.
Good. I've already sent a car for you. Should be arriving any minute. Rita, I understand you're under a lot of pressure. Just rest assured that at my studio, you'll always be protected.
Thank you, Mr. Berman.
See you on set.
I'm sorry. It's a closed set. It's a quick scene. I'll come and get you. Here.
Jack! give me a hand here? We didn't rehearse it this way.
Yeah, well, something's wrong. There's no work scheduled for today. These locks won't budge, they're real.
This is creepy, Jack. Just get me out of here.
Yeah, let me find something to bust these locks with.
Nice to see you again, Rita.
Nolte.
This must be my lucky day. Look, finding you like this, you're almost wrapped up like a little present.
Why don't you give me a hand? That is your job, isn't it?
That's my day job, Rita. This is my night job. You have no idea how long I've waited for this moment. How many other men were in line in front of me? Or how many of them I had to kill?
You killed Johnny.
Johnny? No. No, Johnny, but I killed a lot of them. You want to know why I killed them, Rita? I mean, are you interested at all why I killed them? I killed them because they didn't treat you the way you deserve to be treated. They didn't treat you special. But I'm gonna change all that. I'm gonna treat you real special.
Hey. No. Oh, you, look, okay. One more step and Miss Lake takes her final curtain call.
Ex-cut, Prince! Wonderful detective.
My God, you're obsessed with her. I admire that. It's nothing like a good old death scene to get the blood boiling, eh, Jack? Only I've rewritten the end. You know, I've added a certain touch of reality that I found to be profoundly missing from the script. Where are all the good writers these days? Now, we have a few minutes before the grand finale, and although I think the rope may be a bit archaic, I'm sure we're going to get a big bang when the safe drops on her head.
Who the hell are you?
The editor. I'm sorry, but, well, Rita's already promised me the last dance. Drop the gun.
Well, yeah.
I emptied the chamber when I was in your office.
Excellent move. Well, I guess she's all mine now.
Excellent! See, Jack, run. Remember, Jack, you have a choice. You can save her, or you can come after me. I'm gonna be around a whole lot longer than she will.
Search his pockets for the keys.
Time to get you home.
Atta girl, you won the battle. I am gonna win the war.
Come on. I saw a beam of light shoot out of his gun.
It's a prop from that Martian movie on stage 16.
It looks so real, and then... So what killed Nolte?
We'll have to wait for the coroner's report on that one. You have any idea why he was stalking you?
No. Now that I think of it, I mean, he was always around when there was trouble, but I thought it was because he was a cop.
His badge just made it easy.
I hope this doesn't sound like a line out of some dumb movie, but I've never met anyone like you before.
I'll take that as a compliment. Thank you.
Well, maybe now we can get to know each other better.
I'd like that. But I'm going to be leaving L.A. tonight.
Why?
I have a job offer I'm going to be taking.
You never wanted anything from me. Why?
I wanted something for you. I wanted you to be safe.
She was beautiful.
Innocent. I was framed.
Yes, she was.
Tell me, Logan, when you were alone with Rita, were you ever tempted to, you know, risk changing history?
I'm a total professional, Amix. Thoughts like that never crossed my mind.
Yeah, I'd give anything to be a psychic right now.
Shh, you're missing the best part. Want to see that again?
Oh.
Innocent. I was framed.
Call me incurable romantic, but I like my ending much better.